Hi, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to add border reference to a custom template. They also call them border markers. As usual, you need to start up your Visio and then you open the title block which you created in the previous video. If you missed out the video on how to create title block, please check the reference at the top. So this is the title block we created. Note that we are working on a template. This is not a drawing, this is a visual template. Now the layers are locked, so you cannot move any of the items. I like to work with my favorite friends, pan and zoom, and then size and position. This is how to launch them. You can see with pan and zoom how I can easily navigate through the drawing. We need the layer to stay locked so we can insert the text without altering the border line. Choose a font that is narrow so your text doesn't occupy a lot of space. So the horizontal axis is going to have 0 to 9, that's 10 spaces. The vertical lines are 11 in number, so they're going to take 10 spaces. The 10 spaces will be occupied by 0 to 9. So I'm going to duplicate this to produce the remaining numbers. You can duplicate by pressing Ctrl D or you right click, copy and paste. In positioning the numbers, the first number is going to be at the center of the space, as well as the last number. In order to determine the position that will be the center of your space, divide take the length of the paper, remove the margin you left at the edges, and then divide the remaining by 10, and then you split that into two, and you will get the middle marker for any of the lines. To add it to the first one, you need to add the margin to the middle number, and you have the center of the first space. I hope it's clear. Oops, I did not arrange the numbers properly. As you can see, it says 03 instead of 01, so I'm going to arrange them first before I align a position. Okay, so select the two numbers that I've positioned correctly, then hold Ctrl and select the rest, align to the top and distribute horizontally. This will put all the numbers in the center of the spaces. I need to duplicate this to put the one below. I don't have to repeat the steps, so I group them first. I press Ctrl D to duplicate. Then I can drag or I can cut and paste below. In order to make sure that the one below is properly aligned, I need to select the one at the top first before I select the new one, and then I align to the left, and that is it. Visually, I can see that the vertical alignment is okay, but you can use figures if you want to be certain. So I need to create the ones that are going to be on the vertical axis. Instead of inserting a new text, I removed one from the existing so I don't have to reformat. The vertical axis is going to contain alphabets. There will be 6 spaces, total of 7 lines. So the 6 spaces will be occupied by A to F. So I will position the bottom alphabet using size and position. As you can see, the X says 3 meters, the Y says 20 meters. If you are wondering why we have meters here, please take a look at our previous video on how to create the title block, you will go to the section that talks about drawing scale. You will understand. Then position the A, and then arrange them accordingly. Select the tool that has been properly positioned. Hold Control and select the others. Then align to the left this time around. Then distribute vertically. This will put all of them in their corresponding spaces. Group and then duplicate. This time around, I'm going to copy, go to the other side and paste. Then I need to select the existing one before I select the new one in order to align this time around to the top and position the horizontal axis properly. In order to make smaller movements, you hold shift to make smaller movements. Now let's talk about how to insert text in the title block. Remember, the title block is locked, so in order to be able to access, you need to unlock the title block text layer. So now you click, you can add text. But if you want the text to be automated, then you need to insert field instead. This time around, I want to insert date. We want to insert, say, last edit date. So whenever this document is opened, it will show the last date it was edited in that field. You can choose the format you want. Because of the limited space I have, I will choose this format. Reduce the font size for it to fit into the space provided. And then the sheet. In the last video, I showed you how to insert the sheet field, but this time I'm going to show you how to insert the number of pages. The second figure is supposed to be number of pages, so we go to insert field again. Instead of page number, we select number of pages and we click OK. So for each new page you produce, the total number of pages will appear there. So it will say sheet 1 of 2, sheet 1 of 3, and so on. So we lock back the title block layer and the text block layer, and then we save. The border markers we inserted, we have not assigned them to a layer, so we need to assign them to the border layer. So they will be in the same layer as the border line itself. I need to select all the border markers now, or reference, border reference. Select. You need to hold Control key to be able to do the selection. Now that I've selected all of them, I'm going to assign to layer. Assign to border layer and then lock the border layer. So now our title block is ready with the border reference. To view in presentation mode, so you see this is how it looks. So remember, this is a drawing template, not a drawing itself. What it means is that if you want to make a drawing, then you can use this template as your background. But the good thing is it's an interactive template, so you are allowed to put in your own information on the title block. Remember, it's a template. If you want to see the video of how we created this template, please use the link above to watch the video. Thank you so much. Remember to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. See you next time.